Good morning, dear students. How are all of you? I hope everyone is fine and safe at their homes. And dear students, yesterday we were discussing about the tense, and in tense we discussed about simple present tense. I hope all of you have understood the simple present tense. Today we will start with new topic in tenses, that is present continuous tense. So you must be aware of this term continuous. Continuous means when some action is going on, right? So first of all, we should go through this rule for writing the present continuous tense. Here, subject, as I told you before, in a sentence, subject plays a very important role. So while writing the sentence, we first of all write subject, and then comes the helping verb if it is there. So as we are talking about present continuous tense, so we will be using helping verbs. For that, we to represent that we use be, but for in place of be we can write is, am and are, depending upon the subject. Okay, and then comes verbs first form plus ing. Now this is very important. It shows actually that our tense is in continuous form, the action which is being performed by the subject, that is in the continuous form. And then comes the object, as we all know, right? Now before we start further, I want all of you to be clear with the usage of subject according to the helping verb, like which helping verb should be used with the subject. Here, if I is there, first person I, then with I we have to use am, right? And if we are using you, you is the second person, as I told you in my previous video. We is the plural of first person. They is the plural of third person. Then another plurals, it can be boys, girls, students, right? With that we use are. Then comes third person, he, she, it, this, or singulars. With these terms we will use is. Okay, now here come the uses where to use present continuous tense. Okay, the very first use is, it is used to explain the idea that something is happening now at this moment. Jab bhi koi action abhi ho raha hai, at present, in present time, at this moment, that action is represented with present continuous tense. Okay, so I have taken one example here. We are learning English now. अभी हम क्या कर रहे हैं? हम English सीख रहे हैं. We are learning English now. So here we is the plural of first person. ज़्यादा है, एक से ज़्यादा है. उसके साथ हमने क्या use किया? Are, learn plus ing. This is the present participle form, first form of verb plus ing. Okay, English now. Then second use, to indicate something going to happen in near future. जब भी कोई action आने वाले समय में होने वाला है, उसको भी हम most of the times present continuous tense से भी represent कर सकते हैं. हम उसको future tense से भी represent करते हैं, but we can also represent that sentence with the help of present continuous tense. For example, here we are going on a trip tomorrow. अभी हम गए नहीं है, हमने जाना है कल. तो उसको हम इस form में भी लिख सकते हैं. We can also say we will go on a trip tomorrow, but we can also write it as we are going on a trip tomorrow. तो ये कौन सा यूज हो गया हमारा? To indicate something going to happen in near future. Okay, then third use, used to express longer actions, not now but in progress. उन actions को express करने के लिए भी हम use करते हैं जो अभी काफी समय बाद जाकर complete होंगे, बट वो अभी प्रोग्रेस में है, अभी नहीं हो रहे. एट प्रेजेंट वो एक्शन नहीं चल रहा, बट वो एक्शन अभी प्रोग्रेस में है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई एम लर्निंग टू playing guitar, but I am learning to play guitar. Okay? ठीक है, इसका मीनिंग ये है कि अभी मुझे गिटार बजानी नहीं आती, अभी मैं सीख रही हूँ. सेम वे शी इज स्टडिंग टू बिकम अ साइंस टीचर. अभी वो साइंस टीचर नहीं है, शी इज स्टडिंग, वो अभी स्टडी कर रही है साइंस टीचर बनने के लिए. ठीक है, देन टू डिस्क्राइब समथिंग दैट ऑफन हैपन्स इन नेगेटिव सेंस. जब भी हमें किसी के नेगेटिव एक्शंस को एक्सप्रेस करना है, मीन्स वो कोई हमेशा काम गलत ही करे, कभी सही ना करे, उसको भी हम मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इन सेंटेंसेस से रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं, मीन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्रेजेंट कॉन्टिन्यूअस टेंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, हम कहते हैं, अक्सर कहते हैं कि वो हमेशा क्लास में बात करती रहती है, या वो हमेशा काम पे लेट आता है. तो हाउ वी विल से शी इज ऑलवेज टॉकिंग, राइट? सो हियर टॉकिंग इज अगेन कॉन्टिन्यूअस टेंस. देन यू आर ऑलवेज कमिंग लेट टू वर्क. तुम हमेशा काम पे देर से आते हो या लेट आते हो. ओके, नाउ दीज आर द फ्यू यूजेस दैट हाउ टू यूज present continuous tense, in what situations we need to use that, and this rule which I have written here, which I have told you about, this is mostly used in case of positive sentences. In the positive form of present continuous tense, we have two more forms, negative form and interrogative form. So negative form, जब भी हमें नाम वाली बात करनी हो, हिंदी में आपने पढ़े होंगे नामवाचक वाक्य, right? So the rule for that is we only need to add not here. See here, not I have written, like subject plus is am are plus not plus verb first form plus ing plus object and then full stop. Rest everything is same here, we have only added not here. Then interrogative form, what is the rule? The helping verb will come in the beginning of the sentence, the questioning word which will ask the questions. So interrogative sentences, all of you know, which ask the questions, right? So in that case, we always use helping verbs in the beginning, then comes our subject, then first form of verb, then again ing plus object, and then question mark is very important here to indicate whether the sentence is interrogative or not. Okay? Now here I have written few sentences here. We will practice these here. First of all, I have taken the examples for positive sentences here. Now suppose we are given here this subject, I dash, in bracket we have given main verb, we are given, sorry, main verb, then a letter. Okay? Now if I have to solve this sentence, what will come? We all know with I, which helping verb we are going to write here? Am. Okay, I is the first person. Every time in present continuous tense, we will be using am with I. Okay, then write, write, what we will write here? R-I-T, we will erase this. I-N-G, so we will change the write form into writing form. I am writing a letter. Now, in second case here, you, we, they, boys, I have taken all the subjects all together just to give you example here. You, we, they, boys, all these are plurals. This is second person. This is plural of first person. They, plural of third person. Boys, plural. Here we have to use the form for play verb. Okay? So what will come here? Are. Because these all are plurals, play will change into playing and then full stop. Clear? Then comes he, she, Ram. I have taken all the third persons together here just to give you example here. He, she, Ram. Here verb is given run. Okay? So, he, she, Ram, all these are singulars. With singular, what we are using? Is. He, she, Ram is running. We can do these one by one also. He is running, she is running, Ram is running. Okay? And whenever any person is not there or any place is not there. So what we can write it? It, now we are talking about rain here, we have to use the verb ing form of rain. So it is raining. Okay, now these were the positive sentences. I am writing a letter, you are playing, we are playing, they are playing, boys are playing. He is running, she is running, Ram is running. Okay, then it is raining. Now comes the negative form of the present continuous tenses. An example you can take here. Like here we have written, I am writing a letter. Now if we have to change it into negative form, only not we have to add here, as I told you before. I am not writing a letter. Okay? Then you, they, we are not playing. Right? Then he, she, Ram is not running. Clear? And if I have to change this into negative form, it is not raining. Right? So clear negative form, only not we have to add everywhere to change it into negative sentence. Now comes the interrogative form or interrogative form of present continuous tense. I have taken only two examples. We can change all these also. For example, if I say, now here they, you need to check whether it is singular or plural. Now they is plural. So questioning word, how it will start? Like here I told you, helping verbs we have to use in the beginning. Okay? It can be is, it can be am, it can be are. But here it is plural, they. So what we will write here? With they we know are. Now if I say are they, any verb you can use here, are they playing? Okay, so it becomes a questioning sentence. Now, Seema is singular. With singulars, what do we use? Is. Now, is Seema, any verb you can take, sleeping? Now also you can write, is Seema sleeping now? Okay, now if you have to change these also, I am writing a letter. Questioning form will be, am I writing a letter? Am can come in the place of I and I can come here. Am I writing a letter and question mark, right? Same way here, are they playing? Are you playing? Are we playing? Is he running? Is it raining? So this way we can convert all these sentences into negative or interrogative forms. Okay? So I hope all of you have understood today's topic of present continuous tense. And I will be providing you few assignments for the same. With this are two main types, simple present tense and present continuous tenses covered today. So I would appreciate if you revise all these topics and if you watch my videos properly and listen to them carefully and do your